Good evening, good evening, good evening. Let all the people of God say amen, amen. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in. I was glad, yes, glad, very glad, so glad. When they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord, enter into his gate with thanksgiving. Amen, amen. How are all our friends and all our family out here today? Amen. Evangelist Canada is watching, and thank you always, love, for providing the music for us. Amen. Who else is on with us on this Wednesday evening? On this Wednesday evening, dark outside, but the sun is shining. To all our friends, all our family, we say good evening. Sister Barbara Dye, God bless you. Karen, how you doing? Karen Archer, how's Mark? Christy Dawn is on with us. Amen. Brother George, God bless you. Brother George Goodman, amen. Mother Adamae Jenkins, God bless you. Amen. Look like I see Pee-wee. Evelyn William Kitchen Ruff is joining with us. How's everybody? How's everything in the loop? Good, we know. Amen, amen, amen. To God be the glory for the thing that he has done. How has God blessed you, Evelyn William Kitchen Ruff? Amen, amen. God is such an awesome God, such a good God. He looks beyond all our faults and finds our need. Kelly, D, Dorita, how you doing? Dot, amen, amen. God bless you. God keeps you is our prayer for you. Praying that all you have had a great day today, have a restful evening tonight, and have a better day on tomorrow. How has God blessed you? We say, bless us to see another day. Yes, Lord, you gave us one more bright sunshine a day. And for that, we said, thank you. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Amen. All right. This is it. This is the day. We're going to continue our series on the harvest there. Amen. Continue out of May. Mother Calhoun said, continue to pray for Sister Clara Keys. Sit home from the hospital. Praise God. Good prayer report. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God keeps you is our prayer for you. Amen. Someone shedding tears there. Amen. Pray that God will wipe away all your tears. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Such a kind God. Wonderful God. A blessed God. And we pray for all our community down here locally. Robinsonville, DeSoto County. Amen. Chief Dispin, you and Clara, God bless you. Old sub, new sub, seal sub, walker sub. We pray for all our folks. Amen. And all our cities. St. Louis, Chicago, wherever dispersed. Around the globe and around the country. Memphis, we pray for you. We pray for our children and our children's children. Pray for our schools, amen. Whatever level of school, whether it's kindergarten or Head Start, pre-K, all right. Belinda Bullard on ventilator, all right. Teaching in Holly Springs, we praying for that, amen. We pray that God will be done in all our life, amen, amen. Praise report, you got a praise report, you got any comments, you got prayer requests, go ahead, type them in the comment box at this time. Amen. Katrina John Wolfer, praying for her and that help bothering her. Amen, amen. All right. Let's see, we got some music here. Don't plan on holding you too long, this here. Who we got here with the music? Amen. Stephanie Sims, how you doing? Coleman Niece, how are you doing? Amen, amen. Who we got here? Colorado Mass Choir. I still have joy. After all that we've been through, can we say, can you say, can I say, I still have joy. We've been through a lot. We got some ups and we got some downs. But can we say, I still have joy. Amen, amen. Let's see what the Colorado Mass Choir. After all, praying for Bible, praying for your mom, Georgia Keys, praying for your Aunt Clara, amen. Hope all you had a great day. Been through a lot. Pray, Mother Jenkins said, pray for all her grands, her nieces, and nephews. We got you. Praying for the whole family. Praying for your neighbor. Do you still got joy after all you've been through? After all. Still got joy. We've been through a lot. Trouble, heartache, and pain. Loss of loved one. Still got joy. Bob Hibbler, good evening. How are you doing? You still got joy, Bob? We've been through a lot, but do you still got joy? Through the storm. Heartaches and pain. Brenda Dunlap, good evening. How you doing, niece? All right, Chicago, God bless you. Do you still got joy after all you've been through? All the hurt, all the pain, all the loss. Through the year. Down through the year. I still have joy. People thanking God for a wonderful day. Filled with nothing but joy. Weeping, do it for the night, but joy. Oh, yeah. Still got joy after all you've been through. Still got time. Put your prayer request in the comment box. All right. Thanks for the sound check, Brenda. All right. Sounding good. But early in the morning, still, oh yeah, I still, do you still got your joy? Stanisha, how you doing? Praying for the Love Underwood family. Okay, let's back this up and let's do our prayer list, our evening prayer. Turn it down just a little bit. Prayer list, Pastor Reverend Green Oliver, Pastor Bowles up in Morningstar, Robsonville, Pastor Joel Anderson, Mount Zion, Dub, Deacon Bobby Bond, Deacon Adam Bond, praying for the Conway family, the Patterson family, Major Conway, Melvin Conway, Sharon Ship Conway, Terry the Fox Blue, Fox Smith Weather, Weston Blue, Mary, Bright Sister, Ernestine Webb, Mother Ethel Jones, Mother Lori Hubbard, Mother Marjorie Hibbler, Mother Eunice Thomas, Mother Dar Lauren, Mother Kat Smith, Mother Clara Dishman, the family of Percy Conway, the family of Richard Conway Patterson, Denise Vaughn, praying for Doris, Kimma Robinson. Doris, our classmate, she was taking the hospital this evening, so we pray that everything go all right for them. Praying for the Weston at Batesville, all right, that they locate their son, not been seen since this morning. All right, mother know how it is when you're looking for a child, can't find. Amen. Any other prayer requests, you still can type them in the coming box during the program. But early in the morning, let us pray. Gracious Lord, we thank and praise you for life, for health and strength. So much to be thankful for. And we realize, Lord, that we just don't thank you enough. And so this evening, Lord, for we thank you, for we ask you for anything. We pause and thank you for everything. We realize, Lord, that it's in you we live, move, and have our being. Without you, there's absolutely nothing that we can do. So come now, Lord Jesus. Restore with us that joy. Yes, Lord, we've been through a lot. We've been through loss of family. We've been through death. We've been through sickness. We've been through illness. We've been through coldness. But after a while, we still got joy. So bless us, Lord God, to endure for the night. Weeping endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning. Bless us and keep us and give a word tonight for these thy children that will strengthen them, that will encourage them and brighten their day. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Caitlin and John, how you doing, Caitlin? I still. All right, Colorado Mass Choir, I still got joy. Amen. Still got joy all these years. Amen. Amen. All right. Like I said, we're going to continue with our series on the harvest. All right. We come in tonight out of Galatians chapter 6, verse 7. Galatians chapter 6, starting at verse number 7 down through 10. That's Galatians chapter 6. Verse number 7. See, Jada joined us. These words we find recorded. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever man soweth, that shall he also reap. For he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reach everlasting life. And let us not be weary in well doing. For in due season we shall reap if we faint not. And as we have therefore opportunity, let us do good unto all men, especially unto them who are the household of faith. Amen. Familiar passage there. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever man soweth, that shall he also reap. Amen. Just for a little while, the time that is ours this evening, I don't plan on holding you too long, want to preach sowing and reaping. Sowing and reaping. See if we can get some principles for sowing and reaping. Amen. You see, there is a spiritual principle of reaping what we sow. And I understand that this principle should guide what we sow, how we sow. The Lord give principle in scripture to serve as warning and as encouragement. So we should be encouraged this morning. Sowing and reaping, you know, we down here in rural America, in the Mississippi Delta, are agriculture term. Farmers and gardeners throughout history and throughout the world have depended on this principle to be true nature, all right? And God's word said it's true in agriculture and it's also true in life. We're going to reap what we sow. What a person sows in their life, they will eventually reap. Not because God does something extraordinary to make this happen, because it is a principle that he has established. It has been established by God, and no one can change it. It's not going anywhere. We're going to reap what we sow. Now, from a physical aspect or from an agriculture aspect, that means you plant a cotton, you get cotton. You plant soybean, you get soybean. You plant watermelon, you don't expect to harvest cucumber. All right? We reap, we harvest what we plant. All right, so we're going to look at a few things here this evening, just a couple, three topics, these three headings there. The principles of sowing, the process of sowing, and the product of sowing. Mother Cat Hayes, John Wolf, a good evening, Sister Cat. Amen, got that birthday coming up Friday. The principle of sowing and reaping. All right, those three things, the principle of sowing and reaping, the process of sowing and reaping, and the product. The principle, the process, and the product. Now first, let's look at the principle. Every farmer, every gardener understand the meaning of this principle. We reap what we sow, all right? We reap wider than we sow. We reap well after we sow. Let us look at each part of the principle to make sure we understand what it means and its implication. All right. But the first thing there on the principle of sowing is this. Who reap what is sown? This principle applies to everyone. Now, when you're dealing with harvest, you're still dealing with the same basic three things we have been talking about. All right. The sower, the seed, and the sower. All right. So here we're looking at who reap what is sown. All right. This principle applies to everyone, both Christian and non-Christian. Everyone. All right. This principle is unchanging. No escaping it. No getting away from it for either the believer or for the non-believer. Yes, Kat, I got 3 points in a prayer. It's a fact of life. It's a law of life. We reap what we sow, whether we're Christian or not. Now, Galatians 6:7 tells us to be not deceived. God is not mocked. All right. Now, herein it lies the cause of our careless and sinful lifestyle. All right. We are deceived. Either we think we do not believe the truth, or we think that somehow we are the exception to the to God's law, reaping and sowing. And that is why sinners continue in their path. They believe they are the exception. Why would such a kind and gracious God send folks to heaven? God don't send us to heaven. God fulfilled his promise. We send our own self to heaven or hell. All right. So we understand who reaps. Everyone. Whether Christian, good, bad, or indifferent, everyone is going to reap. All right, so who reaps? I'm going to do who, what, when, and why. All right, what we reap. It's simple. The fact we reap what we sow is good news for those who sow good seed, but a scary thought for those who involve in ungodly activity. Now, let's get this thing here. The worldly application, what we got, the physical, a sowing, planting seed. All right, and reaping the harvest. But from a spiritual aspect, what is sowing and what is reaping? All right, from a spiritual point of view, our sowing is our behavior. All right, and then the harvest are the consequences that we suffer because of our behavior. Physical, planting, and harvesting. Spiritual, all right, behavior, and consequence. Understand this. We cannot be disobedient to God and expect to reap his blessing. What we sow, we reap. I'm just an old farm boy, all right, from Robertsville. But I understand if you plant pinto beans, all right, you're going to get pinto beans. You don't plant pinto beans and expect to harvest some watermelon. We reap what we sow. We do not cause havoc. Sowing seeds of discord and hatred and expect to harvest love and kindness. All right. If we want to see change in our life, we cannot start by trying to reap a different harvest. It has to start by sowing a different seed. All right. So we reap. We reap. All right. Who reaps? What we reap? All right. And understand that we reap wider or wealthier, weightier, that means bigger or larger than we sow. We reap more than we sow. The harvest is much greater than what was sown. All right. Most sowing produce more than what is sown. One seed is multiplied in the minute. All right. Now, let me give you this example. Take the apple. All right, you sow one apple seed and you get a whole tree that produce many apples, and each apple have many seed. All right, you plant one grain of corn. All right, and from that one grain of corn, you get a whole stalk of corn that has many, many ears of corn on it, and each ear has many, many kernels of corn on it. That's the physical planting, sowing. But same thing that works spiritual. We may sow one evil act, all right? One seed that corrupt yield dozen, even hundreds of seed. It is the same way for both sin and righteousness. If we sow a evil seed, that evilness is going to be multiplied. But at the same time, we sow a seed of love, that seed of love also is going to be multiplied. If whether good, bad, our harvest is much bigger than what we sow. And we all going to get a bigger crop. All right. So sow good seed. All right. So we got that. Who reap? That's everyone. What we reap. We reap what we sow. All right. We reap larger or bigger or wider than we sow. All right. When do we reap? All right. We reap after we sow. All right. Now, maybe some might be deceived because their present seed does not appear to be producing an immediate crop. All right. So they continue down their course with their behavior, expecting that they will never be a harvest. But we got news for you. Payday, some way. The crops of the field are going to get harvest. They get harvest at approximately the same time. Sister Steele, this time, every year, the crops get harvest. And you see all kind of cotton pickers, combine, threshers out there gathering in the crop. But there is no understanding, there is no regular timetable for the harvest of life. You reap what you sow later on. Amen. All right. So those are some of God's principles. All right. And those were the principles of sowing. Now let's look at the process of sowing. The process of sowing. Now the scriptures identify two patterns of sowing, all right, and two categories of sower. There are the sowing to the spirit and sowing to the flesh. All right, we see that in the scripture. If I can get it right here now, all right. Verse 8, for he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption, but he that soweth to the spirit shall of the spirit reap everlasting life. So there's just two patterns, two types of sowing. To the spirit, to the flesh. All right. Now, understand here. There are many factors that determine or clearly indicate our pattern of sowing. First, we have the quality of the seed. The quality of your seed. Only viable seed can produce a good yield. You need to examine critically your seed to see whether they're good or not. Now, some may think they're sowing good seed, but in actuality, we're sowing seeds of bad or corrupt seed. So your harvest depends upon a few things. One, the quality of your seed. No farmer want to put bad seeds in the ground, all right? The same thing in life. We should put good spiritual seeds in the soil, all right? Now, let me explain that. We have the seed, the soil, the seed, and the soil. We know who those are, all right? Now, we still have those, all right? The seed the soil are us in this particular part. We're the one, and the seeds are our behavior. We are the soil, the seeds are our behavior, and the harvest is the consequence for our behavior. So we have the quality of your seed. All right. Now we have the quantity, meaning numbers. Quality, meaning its value. Quantity, meaning its number. Your yield, your harvest, will depend on the volume and amount that you sow. How many acres do the farmers cover? All right. Second Corinthians 9:6 talks about sowing sparingly and reaping sparingly. He who sows sparingly shall also reap sparingly. But he who sows bountifully shall reap also bountifully. So we need to sow a lot so we can get a lot back. And it's coming back. Cast thy bread up on the water. After many days, it will come back. Hundredfold, a thousandfold. It's coming back. It's coming up. Whether you sow good seed, bad seed. Whether you sow evenness, or whether you sow love, it's coming back. So we have that. The quality of your seed. The quantity of your seed. Now we have the question of the soil. When a good seed is placed in bad soil, or a bad seed is placed in good soil, a favorable result cannot be obtained. It just won't happen. We need to examine, all right, the soil, our behavior, in the light of the Word of God, all right, and the guidance of the Holy Spirit to see if it constitutes good soil or bad soil. All right. Talk about the process now. The quality of our seed, the quantity of our seed, the question of the soil. You need good soil. And we have the quakes, Q-R-K, quakes of the soil. Now, quake just means a particular behavior habit. There's nothing inherently bad about a quake. It is a pattern of habitual behavior. Even after planting good seed and good soil, we need to follow up. The farmer has to follow up when he plants good seed and good soil, all right? He got to water it. He got to fertilize it. He got to weed it. He got to plow it. And so even after the seed is planted, it still must be nurtured. Amen. That's good seed, all right? Now, spiritual care, all right, for our seed, the good seed that we planted, include prayer, taking some positive step, all right, to be guided, led by the Holy Spirit. And that was the process of sowing, which we look at the quality of the seed, the quantity of the seed. We looked at the question of the soil. Is it good soil or bad soil? We look at the quakes, all right, which means just behavior of the soil. Now, you plant a garden. Do you just leave it? Do you let the weeds take care of it? Do you water it? All right. Do you chop it? Okay, so that's nurturing. Even as you plant good seed, our children, we put good seeds in them, all right? And when they're young, they are good soil. But still, mother, still, father, you have got to nurture it. You have got to train them up, bring them up in the fear and admiration of the Lord. Amen. All right. So we looked at the principles of sowing. Then we looked at the process of sowing. Amen. And lastly, we're going to look at the products of sowing. The product of sowing. And as we found out earlier, it's just two type. All right. We sow into the spirit. All right. And we sow into the flesh. Do you hear me? We sow into the spirit or to sow into the flesh. Now that's the question of the soil. Is it good soil or is it bad soil? Now let's look at this. Sow into the flesh. In every believer, every Christian, every child of God, the flesh works contrary to the spirit. And the only way of victory over the flesh is we have to yield to the Holy Spirit. Let the Holy Spirit lead us and let the Holy Spirit guide us. It's the only way we can overcome the flesh. Come here, Paul, and witness for me in Galatians 5 and 16. Walk in the spirit and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Do you hear me? Only two types of products. Spirit of flesh. That's what we're going to reap. All right. That's what we're going to harvest. If we sowed into the flesh, we're going to reap into the flesh. If we sowed into the spirit, we're going to reap into the spirit. Only those two products. Good, bad, good and evil. All right. Those two problems. And we have got to walk in the spirit. All right. Evangelist kind of always said that what you nourish, what you feed, that is going to grow. All right. So whatever you nourish, if you sow good seed, but don't nourish it, it's going to go bad. If you sow bad seed and nourish it, you're going to grow bad seed. All right. So what you feed is going to grow. Now, sowing in the flesh, or sowing seeds of the flesh, constitute a makeup of everything we do that is not pleasing to God or that is disobedient to his word. The results of sowing to the flesh is a harvest of corruption. This means nothing relevant, nothing good in the kingdom of God can be achieved. All external blessing, all inheritance, all of God's favor, all of God's work are forfeited here on earth. My. And that means we have nothing. Understand, God is a righteous judge. God, he's a righteous judge. He will truly reward everyone, those quirks and just behavior, according to his work here on earth. Question, what type of harvest are you envisioning for you in the future? Just two. All right. Flesh, spirit. Flesh or spirit? All right. Now, we need to concentrate on the harvest and be motivated to change our pattern of sower. All right. Understand this. The harvest is not going to change. And the harvest cannot change until we change what is being sown. We have to sow to the spirit. We have to plant those good seed in good soil. Then we will have a great harvest. Remember, the harvest is much more than what is planted, what is sown. You plant one watermelon seed and you get a whole vine full of watermelon, and each watermelon has a million gazillion number of seed. That's the law. All right. We reap more than we harvest. So I said this, if we just sow a little love, all right, then that will be multiplied and we will harvest much more love than we sow. All right. If we display a little faith, all right, if we sow just a little faith, that will be harvest much, much more. If we give our tithes and our offering, 10%, give just a little bit, 10%, all right, we will reap much, much more than we sow. Blessing, Malachi said, it will open up the windows and pour you out a blessing that you don't have room enough to receive. Amen. So we're going to reap what we sow. And so we looked at sowing and reaping, and understand this, we cannot change the harvest unless we change the planting, all right? It's too late once it's planted. It's coming up. So we have to change what is being sowed. We have to sow good seed, all right? And the good soil, and we cannot sow good seed in the good soil because we are not good soil. Come out, David, in number 51 and witness for me. Behold, I was shaped in iniquity and in sin. Bad seed, bad soil did my mother conceive me. So we are bad seed. We are bad soil from the beginning. The seed, remember, is the word of God. And once God, all right, David kept on saying that, create in me a clean heart. Lord, come into my life and clean up this nasty filthy soil and make it good soil. And then your seed will fall on good soil. Lord, once you see me, I become good soil. Lord, once I'm born again, I become good soil. Lord, I can only do this by confessing Christ as my Lord and my Savior. I got to believe in my heart and confess with my mouth that God raised him from the dead. And yes, he did when they whooped him up the hill called Calvary, where they hung him high, stretched him wide. He hung his head and he died, took him down, put him in a grave. But the grave couldn't hold him because early the third day, he got up with all power in his hand. He caught the cloudy escalator and went on home. But he's coming back for his harvest, for his church, without spot or without rancor. And I don't know about you, I'm ready for the harvest, for Jesus to gather in his crop and take us home to forever be with the Lord. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Praise God. Amen. 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 Let's see what evangelist got. William Murphy. It's working. It's working. This is my season. This is your season. For grace. For favor. For favor. Are you ready? For grace. For season. This is your season. To reap, reap what you sow. This is your season. For grace, your season. Your season to reap. Invitations extended. We offer you Christ, the Son of the Living God. God bless you, Mashiach. God didn't ask her to be perfect. He asked her to be faithful. Come now. All we have is right now. Give your heart to God. Give your hand to one of these pastors, preacher, teacher, deacon. God got a purpose. Got a seed in the ground. Good seed in good ground. A bountiful harvest. Got a seed in the ground. And it's working. Who got their seed in the ground? Whose season is it? Brenda's your season. Bob, your season. Evangelist, your season. Christy, Karen, Katrina, it's your season to reap what you sow. It's coming up again, and hopefully we all sow good seed. For grace, for favor, to reap. My season, to reap. Oh yeah, Callie's your season. Stephanie is your season. Cat, your season. Adamay is your season. Chief Dishman is your season. Claire, everything is working. Michelle's your season. We're going to reap what we sow. Together. Everything is working for your good. The world might have meant it for bad, but God turned that thing around and meant it for good. It's good. It's good. It's good. It's good. Say that. It's working for my good. It's good. Is it? If it's your season, say hallelujah. Say amen. It's good. Barbara, it's your season. Oh yeah, Caitlin, it's your season. Pee Wee, it's your season. Hallelujah.
For grace.
For grace. For favor. Favor, God, divine blessing and approval. Amen. Oh, yeah. All right, let's pause it right here. Let's go ahead and get some announcement, and we're going to close out with it's working. We're trying to figure it out. God has already worked it out. All right. Just want to send a special shout out to Elder Pratt of Scott Chapter and Pastor Rob Lanier down at New Stranger Rest down in Dundee for always going beyond the call above and beyond the call of duty. God bless you. All right. Okay, this coming Sunday, we will be live in the sanctuary. All right. Those of you that are joining us from podcasts online, we still will be broadcasting at 11 o'clock, but we'll be coming live from the sanctuary of New Corinth Church out on Runner Road. Let's continue to pray for our children, pray for their schooling. COVID is still here. Pray for our leaders. Amen. Remember, it's coming up again. You're going to reap what you sow. That's God's law. You can't plant cucumber and expect to get peanuts. All right. If you want to change your harvest, then you got to change what is planted. If you're tired of getting meanness and evenness, then stop sowing evenness. You're going to reap what you sow. You can't sow nastiness and evenness and expect to sow love. You got to change your sowing to reap the harvest of love. Amen. God bless you. God keeps you. Don't forget, share this message with your friends, with your family, and with your network. Remember, this is your season. Let's back this up. Everything working together for your good. Let me get some volume here. Don't forget, share this with friends, family, and network. It's good. It's good. Let us pray. Gracious Lord, we thank and praise you for life, for health, and strength. So much to be thankful for. And we realize, Lord, that we just can't thank you enough. We thank you for working out everything for our good. Now, may the love of God, the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide with you now, henceforth, and forevermore. And the people of God said, amen. God bless you. Thank you for your contribution. Amen. Thank you for your contribution to this ministry. It's much appreciated and it's much needed. Amen. It is enabling us to stay on the broadcast. Amen. To stay preaching and teaching God's word. Amen. It's your season to be blessed. Amen. God bless you. God keep you is our prayer for you. Amen. Amen. Leaning.
In whose direction?
In
my direction. Come on, you ain't no need to say it.
You got to say it. Say it.
He's leaning. In my direction.
He's leaning in your direction. God bless you. God keep you is our prayer for you. Amen. Remember, sow good seed. To God be the glory. Have a blessed evening.